Convicted cop killer Michael Astorga is one step closer to getting the death penalty.
This morning, a jury decided Astorga did intentionally kill a Bernalillo County deputy. Action 7 News reporter Alana Greenfogle spoke with both families. She is live from the courthouse.
Very different reactions from those families here in Santa Fe. The parents of James McGreen, who was shot and killed while on duty, say this is the moment they've been waiting for. Justice. On the other hand, Astorga's wife says she wants the jury to tell her kids why they're possibly okay with killing their father. Michael Astorga walked into the courtroom knowing today is different. It's the day he'll find out whether he'll spend his life in prison or if there's still a chance he'll be executed.
We unanimously find beyond a reasonable doubt the aggravating circumstance.
And with those words, the case moves on, and Astorga still faces the death penalty.
The death penalty hanging over the killer's head would make me happy and would give me peace.
Deputy James McGreen's parents have fought tirelessly for this moment.
We've always tried to push for the max.
Saying the man who killed their son deserves nothing more than knowing he will be put to death.
We pushed 6 years to get to this point.
The McGreens didn't get a lot of sleep last night after hearing what sounded like doubt from the jurors yesterday.
He doesn't have a heart. He's cold. No feeling.
But after only about an hour of deliberating this morning, the jury decided the case will move forward with the death penalty phase.
Last night I put myself in God's hands. And I prayed for the right thing to happen, to move the jurors in the right direction. And God's working.
Astorga's wife says she's been bracing herself for the death penalty possibility since the beginning. She said the truth is under a boulder, and until that boulder is cracked or moved, we won't know what truly happened. Doug?
The jury deliberated for 5 hours yesterday, and it seemed, based on their questions, they had doubts even about his innocence. Why the 180?
We won't really know why the jury made this decision, but you're right. After only about an hour this morning, they reached a verdict that surprised a lot of people. So the prosecution says, well, maybe the jurors just got some sleep and got some clarity. Defense disagrees. They think some of the jurors who may have had doubts were intimidated to change their mind by other jurors. They just hope those jurors who believe in Astorga's innocence will now stand up to the rest. Reporting live in Santa Fe tonight, Alana Greenfogle, KOAT Action 7 News.
And tomorrow is a big day in court where the defense will make its pitch as to why Astorga should live. We'll tell you about the defense's plan and what parts of it the judge shot down coming up tonight.